Today we're out in the shop and I'm finishing up my Savioy Marchetti S62 racer, 1929 Schneider Cup racer. And the only thing I have left to do on this is put the pivot bearing in. So a lot of people have asked me on the comments like how I do this. It's pretty simple. So first of all, let me show you how the pivot bearing works. Come over here to the drafting table. I've drawn a diagram. So here's the pivot bearing cut from 1/4 inch tubing. And then I have a little ball, a brass ball bearing. I'm using brass so it won't rust. You can use anything that's convenient. And you just use a 1/4 inch drill bit. Here's the diagram for the seaplane. If you buy plans, here's some purchase plans of a Pelican. They show you, it's handy to buy plans because they show you where the pivot bearing goes. And notice it's in front of where the wings rotate. This particular one. You have to find the balance point of the whole Whirligig before you drill that hole. Okay, and when you're drilling that hole, there's some important things to remember. When you're drilling your hole for your pivot bearing in your Whirligig, here's the Pelican that I just set the plans for. In this case, for the Pelican, I'm going to show you how I set it up. So I use a drill press, and I make sure the table of the drill press is 90 degrees to the drill. And then I want to set this up on here and make sure that the body of the bird, of course you drill it in the bottom. You want to make sure this is 90 degrees to the table, like this. I want the body of the Pelican to be 90 degrees. Otherwise, when you put him on your pivot, he's going to sit like this. The other thing to consider is getting the body 90 degrees to the pivot, because if the pivot is at the wrong angle, he'll be sitting like this or like this. So that's why I use, when I turn this up, the body upside down. Of course, I do this before I put the wings on. And I turn the body upside down. I set the height of the table. And then I use just a regular carpenter square. You can clamp this to make sure that it stays straight as your drill bit goes in. Also, I like to use these 1, 2, 3 blocks. I've talked about these before. They're 90 degrees. They're really nice for doing setups like this. You can just clamp your body of your Whirligig against the 1, 2, 3 block, and it will hold it 90 degrees to the table when you drill it. So I've already drilled the hole in the airplane, and I did it on the drill press. So now I need the bearing. So I buy these in 1 foot lengths. This is 1/4 inch. With a 3/16 hole brass tubing. Get this from Cherry Tree Toys. I don't like to put the tubing right in the vise because you'll flatten it. You put marks on it, you'll flatten it, then it won't fit in the hole. So I made this little block. This is just a piece of wood with a 1/4 inch hole drilled in it. And then I sawed it in two. So this keeps me from crushing the tubing in the vise. So I'll leave about, 2 inches showing here. And I get my handy digital calipers. I got those on 1.5 inches because that's how deep. For these size Whirligigs, I drill them 1.5 inches. The end of these calipers have a pin that sticks out for measuring into holes. So I just use that, hold my saw against it like this, and start the saw curve at 1.5 inches. I already cut that out. We'll come over here. I'm going to set my airplane up. Put the hole in. Now, before I put the pivot bearing in,
I've got the seaplane body upside down on the workbench, propped up with the 1, 2, 3 blocks. I've already put the BB in. It's already gone in the hole. So now, I take my 1/4 inch tubing and just tap it in. The brass is pretty soft, so you don't want to damage it. So I just use a dowel to tap it in. Okay, so I have it in there now. I tapped it in. I leave a little bit of a lip so it's easier to find. And then your pivot pin can go right in there. it's nice and straight to the body of the airplane. So that'll make for a nice Whirligig. Rotates nice and freely on that little bearing. Okay, here's one of my favorite books for Whirligigs. Lund, Andy Lund from North Carolina. He did these books in the 80s. This has lots of plans, and it shows this method of using the pivot pin and explains it. It even explains it for the arm waving variety of Whirligigs, which are kind of hard to set up to balance in the wind so that they blow properly. But there's a whole diagram here. I'll put it up to the camera. So there's a bird Whirligig, and you can see the pivot pin, the socket, and how it's all set up. And that's Whirligig's design and construction. There's two different covers for this. I think this is the older one. The other book is Whirligigs for Wood Carvers by Michael P. O'Neill. This is more in the realm of wood carvers, but he does have a couple designs in there. He's got the bald eagle, and he has a soldier, and he has the pivot pins for his. Here's the bald eagle. Now that's an arm waver type, but you could make it just with the regular wings like I do. But you see how he's got the pivot point marked for the balance? That's Whirligigs for wood carvers. I will put a link to these two. These are paperbacks. They're everywhere. They're on Amazon, thrift books. I'll put a link to them in the description below. So that's the pivot pin. Thank you.